Good day to everyone. Today we will see how a three-phase induction motor is wired for star running and for delta running. Further, we'll see how this motor is started with star connection first and switched to delta connection with the help of separate contactors and a delay timer. First of all, let's see how the ends of three collie sets in a three-phase induction motor is connected at the terminal box of the motor. U1, U2, V1, V2, and W1, W2 coil ends are marked for easy reference here. Even if it is not marked originally, you can use a multimeter and check the connectivity of lower set of coil ends to the upper ends of three coils and mark the six ends accordingly. To start with, we have this three-phase line, and we will take a three-pole circuit breaker and a contactor as the main one for this motor. Let's include a thermal overload also, and will be fixed to the contactor like this. From the three-phase line, connection to be taken to the three-pole breaker, and from it to the points of L1, L2, and L3 of main contactor. Three-phase lines are marked with red, yellow, and blue colors respectively. From the thermal overload, connection given to the three ends of the coils at the motor terminal box, namely U1, V1, and W1. Let's connect this motor with star connection first, and the wiring related to it is shown at the top right corner here. You can see U1, V1, and W1 ends are connected to the red, yellow, and blue lines respectively, and the other three ends of U2, V2, and W2 are joined together in a star connection. So we need to connect those three ends together at the motor terminal box too. To do that, we need a metal plate like this, and when connected it at the terminal box, you will see the motor starts running. Motor runs with its coils connected with star connection now. Let's see how this motor run with a delta connection, and the diagram is shown here at the top right corner. Here you will see, U1 and W2 ends are connected with red line, and need the same to be done at the motor terminal box too. Then you will see here, V1 and U2 coil ends are connected with yellow main line, and we need that too at the terminal box. Likewise, W1 and V2 coil ends are connected to the blue main line, and is to be done at the terminal box here. To do this, we need three metal plates like this, and when connected at the terminal box accordingly, motor starts running with delta connection now. Although star and delta running of a three-phase motor is possible one at a time like this, changing from star connection to the delta connection during running need a different arrangement. For that we need two more contactors, and the first one we name as delta contactor. The other one, obviously, should be star contactor. To connect these to the motor, first we consider delta connection, and is shown here at the bottom right corner. Here again, U1 need to be connected to W2, and is on red main line. Earlier, we straight away connected these two together at the terminal box, but here we do it differently, since star connection 2 involves now. From the main contactor top, we can arrange a line from red phase, through delta contactor, to the W2 at terminal box. Here you will see, red phase is connected to U1, and W2 coil ends now. Yellow line need to be connected to V1, and U2 ends, and taken like this to the U2 end at the terminal box, also through the delta contactor. Likewise, blue phase need to be connected to W1 and U2, and the wire is taken from main contactor top, to the delta contactor, and onto the U2 end of terminal box. Now, by operating the delta contactor, power to the motor can be supplied or disconnected, with coils are on delta connected arrangement. Then we go to the star connecting of the motor, and at the right side bottom corner, star diagram is given. Here, U2, V2, and W2 coil ends are connected together, and need to do the same at the motor terminal box too. We can connect wires from W2, U2, and V2 to the bottom of the star contactor first, and then on the upper side of the contactor, join the three points together. So you got the star contactor also connected to the system now, and let's see how this setup operates the motor. Starting of the motor should be done with star connection, to avoid high current draw at the start, and after few seconds, need to shift the motor to the delta connection, for more powerful running with higher torque and high current. For this changes to be done, we need a timer and is provided here now. All the contactors are at off position, including the timer. After switching on the three pole breaker, you need to switch on the MCB of the control wire circuit also, and is not shown here. When you press the start button of the motor control, motor receives power through timer, main contactor, and the star contactor. When motor reaches 75 to 80% of its full speed, star connection can be changed to delta connection. Motor needs only few seconds to reach this speed, and normal timer adjustment for star contact to run period is around 5 to 10 seconds only. After this time period passes, timer stops the star contactor, and the motor is without power supply for a very short period of time, and is called pause time. Between star to delta changing, there should be a very small delay period of around 50 milliseconds to avoid short-circuiting of the system. After the pause time, star delta timer sets delta contactor to operate the motor, and will continue operation till it being stopped. Hope you got fair idea on how the star delta starter operates to start the three-phase induction motor on star connection initially, and changes to delta connection thereafter. If this video is helpful, please subscribe the channel for more videos. Thank you.